What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I am back. As you can see from the title, I'm just gonna do a get ready with me type of video because I really wanted to put something up for you guys. I know last week I didn't post anything because I was sick, and so I didn't really have like a solid thought as to what I wanted to do. So I just figured a get ready with me would be like a good way to kind of use some products on video that I have not yet used and show you how I'm liking things, so on and so forth. So let's go on ahead and dive right in. I'm gonna go on ahead and prime my skin using my Hourglass Mineral Primer. As you can see, I'm not having a great skin day or week, mainly because it's probably like my body is detoxing from being sick all last week. I was down with a sinus cold. It wasn't quite an infection, but when I do get sick, that's usually like the type of cold that I get because I have really bad allergies, and the weather here in Ohio has been really fucking weird. I feel like everywhere right now, but last week we had a couple of days that it was like in the 70s, like 72 all the way up to like 76 degrees, and then it like shot all the way back down to like 30 something degrees this past weekend, and now it's like gradually getting warmer again. It's weird, but my body is not happy about it, obviously. So like I said, I want to use some things that I haven't yet used on camera and some things I picked up over the course of the past few weeks or whatever. I got this Makeup Forever sample with a Sephora order like a while ago. I don't think that I used it on camera before. I'm in the shade, I'm assuming this is a shade number or name. It's 128 or Y415. I don't know. I know they switched up like the formula of the HD, or I don't know. Anyways, so yeah, I'm using this today. I think it's a little too dark for me. Well, no, I think I might be good. So yeah. Like I said, I was sick last week, and I just really haven't had a chance to sit down and film too much lately because of my life, but I believe to be getting back on schedule this week. I'm gonna use my beauty blender to blend this out. And also another reason why I haven't been able to film too much, if you guys follow me on Instagram or Snapchat, you have seen that we have a new addition to the family. We adopted a dog. Her name is Annabelle. It was my youngest daughter's birthday gift. It was a surprise for her birthday. She's been begging to get another dog, and she's also been begging for a little sister, which won't be happening because mama doesn't plan on having any more children. We have three, that is plenty. And my body is shut down for good. But yeah, so she's been asking for a dog. So we went on ahead, me and my husband have been looking at the local dog shelter for some time now. And I told him, you know, it really doesn't matter to me what type of dog we get. All that mattered to me was that it was healthy and it was starting off young, like a young puppy, because obviously we wanted to grow with our family. So my husband, he's been going for like the past few months, going in there and checking everything out, seeing what they had in and so on and so forth. And I was like, if I go, then I'm leaving with a puppy. So I went the Friday before her birthday, about 3 weeks ago now, and I got the puppy. Her name is Annabelle. She's a pit bull mix. She's asleep right now because I just took her to the vet and had like shots and everything done. So she's a little wore out. I'm gonna put like a second layer on my problem areas. So yeah, she's been keeping us pretty busy and getting us outside a lot, and which is all good because I'm trying to get back in the habit of working out more. I was doing really good for a while and I kind of fell off, mainly because of I made the decision to like quit my gym membership because I wasn't going as much as I thought that I would have. And I was like, maybe I'll get another membership somewhere else, so on and so forth. Well, that didn't work out because I was like, oh, I'll just work out at home and blah, blah, blah. I haven't been working out. It's bad. But yeah, so I'm about to get my gym membership back. So I'm gonna get back on top of things. And also I just got a package sent to me from a company that sells like the teas or whatever. And I'll have like a separate video talking more about that once I actually start it. I plan on starting it this week, so you guys can see the progress and all that jazz. I'm using my usual brow product, which is the ColourPop brow color. This stuff has lasted me a really, really long time. So I am thoroughly impressed and enjoying this $6 brow product. Y'all better stop playing if y'all ain't tried it. I don't know how to do my brows using a pencil, so these type of products for me are best. Shit's about to get serious, so I'll probably just speed through this. All right, so I think my brows are as good as they are gonna get. I need to wax right now, so don't judge my lifestyle. What else did I want to talk to you guys about? So yeah, we got the puppy. I've been sick, which is why I've been MIA. I'm about to get back on track with my workouts and stuff. I'm turning 30 this year, you guys. And I'm not sad about it or anything. I've been talking to a lot of people about it. And I'm like, I'm not really stressed out with the fact that I'm getting older because it's the inevitable, but you know, it's just like, it's a big year. So I kind of want to do something to like celebrate. So I don't know. You guys should give me some ideas as to what I should do for my 30th birthday. I thought about doing a party. My birthday is in April and it's already pretty much March. So I'm like, if I'm going to do that, then I probably should be like getting my life together and like really getting things planned out. But I really want to travel. I wanted to go to IMATS and my husband agreed to roll to New York with me, and one of my girlfriends is going too, but he's BSing around on the details with that. So I don't know if that's actually something that's gonna happen because I haven't even bought tickets yet and stuff like that. I don't know, but maybe I'll go to another trade show that's coming up soon. But yeah, I just set my eyes with the Urban Decay primer potion and I have no idea what I'm doing on my lids. I think it's going to be something pretty basic because I'm not doing anything today. What do I want to use? I grabbed my Naked Basics 2 palette because again, like I said, I want to do something just pretty basic. So I am going to take, what's it called? Stark, and put it all over my lid. Take Cover and put it in my crease. I'm actually gonna switch my brush out. I really need to wash my brushes. What's you guys' favorite brush cleaner? I've been using the Dr. Bronner's cleaner for, well, not cleaner, but the Dr. Bronner's solid soap. I use the tea tree. I believe that's the one that I use for a while, but I don't know. I feel like I need to switch it up. Damn, I kind of jacked that up. So you guys should let me know down in the comments which cleaner that you like, or what do you use. I've tried the Beauty Blender solid soap before and it's pretty good. I haven't tried the liquid though. So if you guys have tried the liquid, you should let me know what you think of it, because I kind of want to try it out just to see. All right, I'm gonna go back into Stark just to kind of help blend this out a little bit. So it went a little too hard, harder than what I was planning on anyways. All right, and just for a little bit of definition on my outer corner, I'm going into Undone, just like, bring a little bit of depth on the corners there. I'm just gonna dot it and then blend it out. And lastly, I'm gonna take Skimp with this shader brush. I just found this brush in my collection. I forgot all about it, honestly. Holy crap, that's pigmented. I put that on pretty sloppy, which is totally fine because I'm just gonna blend it. Alright, so what else do I want to do? I'm going to go ahead and conceal using the Master Conceal by Maybelline. I feel like I always run out of shit to talk about when I do these Get Ready With Me's where I actually talk through. I'm just not a big talker. I don't know if you guys knew this or not, but I'm a little bit more introverted. So I don't talk a whole lot anyways in real life. Well, obviously I do for my job, but other than that, like I'm not a big talker. I don't chat it up a whole lot. So I finally broke down and picked up some of the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I just got like the little guy because I just wanted to try it out, and I have way too many damn translucent powders as is. So I just wanted to give this one a whirl. So I'm just gonna use my Beauty Blender to apply. Also gonna go on ahead and use this to set my forehead and around my nose, because that's usually where I end up losing a lot of my foundation. My camera completely cut off where I actually set my face using the photo bomb. Well, after I set my under eye and like around my nose and stuff with the Laura Mercier, I did go ahead and set my face using the Balm's Photo Bomb, which I have absolutely been loving. And I did use the contour shade out of the highlight and contour palette. So now moving on, what do I wanna do next? Let me see. So I didn't do any blush or anything yet, so I guess I'll go ahead and do that. I'm just gonna use the blush out of this palette since I have it handy, which I really do like this color. I feel like it's, you know, a pretty universal blush color for, you know, many skin tones and many, many looks. It just adds like a softness to your face. So yeah, All right, so now let's go ahead and finish up the eyes. I am going to give myself a wing because I haven't in a really, really long time. I don't know, like I haven't been doing a whole lot of makeup lately, really, really basic makeup looks for the most part. And eyeliner has not been a part of my life on a day-to-day basis. So I wanna switch it up today. I'm not very good with these type of eyeliners either. This is the Balm Schwing eyeliner, which is like, you know, your typical liquid eyeliner. Not good with this at all, so my shit will not be perfect, but that's fine. I don't want anybody to feel like, you know, I'm the greatest with makeup or anything, because I'm really not. I just really, really like it. All right, so I think that's as good as it's gonna get today for you, girl. All right, so I do want to define my lower lash line a little bit. So I'm going to take a little bit of primal, just a little bit to kind of add some definition on my lower lash line. I know what else I wanted to talk to you guys about. So obviously, like, my house is ever changing, because if you guys didn't know, I moved like back in the summer, so we've been doing a lot of like renovations and everything to our home, to our new home, because, you know, it just wasn't up to our standards. So where I was filming was like in this opposite corner here, which is in my dining room. And this will be changing very soon, because I am looking for a dining room table, so I won't have just the blank space or the extra space anymore to have my whole little setup going on. Oh, by the way, I'm using the Tarte Inner Rim Liner, and it's just a nude color, obviously. So that will be something that I have to figure out as well. I know that you guys remember seeing the ugly green paint color that I have in my bedroom. I'm actually hoping that I'm gonna get it painted this week or next. So my filming setup might change according to that. I may end up upstairs in my room again. Just until I can figure something else out. Eventually our basement is going to be finished, and I believe I'm going to have an office down there, so that may be my filming setup for good once it is there. What do I want to use? I'm going to go into the Minizer Sisters and use Mary Lou Minizer on my inner corner of my eyes. So yeah, that's what I'm hoping. I mean, like I said, it could be different. I don't know. Hopefully that's what it'll be though, because I'm kind of getting tired of, you know, me having to constantly move my stuff around and everything like that. It's just is what it is right now, which is also why it's been kind of difficult for me to remain consistent with my filming. But like I said, hopefully all of that will be changing really, really soon. I may be in a few different setups for the next few months, but again, eventually I do plan on getting my basement finished and I'll have an office. So that will be, you know, the forever spot. But until then, you know, just expect to see different backups, backgrounds every time. Right now I'm still in my dining room, by the way, let me clarify. But right now we have the new puppy's crate that's over there, and I don't want to have to move it. So I'm next to my entertainment system, like the little transition between my front room and the dining room space. But yeah, this stuff, I mean, it's going to be difficult for a little while, but it'll be all right. I want to perfect my eyeliner a little bit, because I did a trash ass job, and as it's dried, I can really see where I messed up, so I wanna fix that. There we go, that's better. Well, at least I feel better about it. Okay, what else do I wanna use? I guess I can go on ahead and add my highlight. I'm just gonna use Mary Luminizer, which is pretty much what I always use. I can't help it, it's a favorite for a reason. I have many, many highlighters, but this is one that I'm always satisfied with for obvious reasons. Hello, it's the bomb. Also, I needed you guys' help just to help me kind of figure out what you guys like to see, how frequently you want to see things from my channel. As of, for the most part, I release 2 videos a week, and I want to continue that, but I do need to get more on like a consistent schedule as far as the days that I film or the days that I actually post and what time to post and everything like that. So I want you guys to let me know, is 2 videos per week too much, or should I just stick to once a week, or what are the days that you wanna see me drop my videos, everything like that. Like, I need you guys' feedback because I just wanna make sure when I'm releasing things, number one, you guys are always getting it. So one way that you can always get it, you can hit like the little bell next to the subscribe button. If you're not subscribed, obviously subscribe if you wanna see more of me. But then two, if you wanna get a notification every single time I release a video, go on ahead and hit that little bell and it will notify you every single time I drop a video. I'm gonna use this Milani setting spray. I really like this stuff. It smells really nice, all this good stuff. But yeah, I want you guys to help me. Like, I need the motivation to keep pushing this channel because I really, really wanna grow my channel. This was the year for me to be like, all right, I'm gonna take this more seriously and I'm gonna release consistent material and or content and everything. But I really need you guys to help me out as far as, you know, how often you want to see my videos, what day you want to see my videos, and also what kind of videos that you want to see, because I want to make sure that I'm bringing you guys stuff that you like. So obviously I'm always posting like get ready with me's, which you guys should probably let me know. Well, I would love for you guys to let me know if you like a get ready with me, a more like talked through tutorial, kind of sped through tutorial. Like, what do you like when you're looking at tutorials? Because I usually like doing the more like sped through things because I feel like, you know, obviously there's some steps that are really, really repetitive and I have a few like foundation routines already out there. So if you like that, let me know. If you like it when I talk to you guys and actually explain what I'm doing and showing you each product and each brush and so on and so forth, definitely let me know if that's something that you're interested in as well. Either way, I just want to make sure that I'm doing what you like. I'm here for you. Now I'm going to go on ahead and put on my mascara. I got these as like a 500 perk point at Sephora. I don't know why that was a struggle, but it's the Super Enhancing Mascara Base by Lancome in the Hypnos Drama. I used this last night for the first time and this shit is amazing. I don't know if the primer actually made a difference, but you know, it made my lashes look nice. So starting off with this, and then we shall move on to the Hypnos Drama. But yeah, I just wanna make sure that, you know, I'm keeping this going and that you guys are getting everything that you like from me. And also, other than tutorials, I don't do subscription boxes anymore. mainly because I have so many products and hair products, makeup products, and I really want to get like specific things when I do shop for makeup or when I do get makeup. But I do like picking up like the limited edition boxes and stuff like that. So the Curl Box Natural, the Curl Box Body, stuff like that, I will pick up and unbox with you guys. But I also want to make sure that's something that you want to see. And then two, towards the beginning of the year, I asked you guys if you wanted to see more hair tutorials or hair videos or product reviews and stuff like that from me. So definitely let me know if that's what you want to see. Alright, so I was going to put on lashes, but I think I'm going to pass on them today because I'm not doing anything. But to round everything all the way together, I'm going to go ahead and use the Jordana lip liner in Coco Loco. Oh yeah, there was one more thing that I wanted to share with you guys. So this past weekend, Miel Organics had like a meet and greet in my town in Columbus, Ohio. This is the Hourglass Girl, what is this called? The Hourglass Girl Lip Stylo in the shade Influencer, which is just like a really pretty nude. I picked this up just yesterday actually, and I haven't had a chance to use it yet, so I'm excited. Oh, this is the moisture that I need right now. My lips are so dry. I really like the way these feel. If you guys didn't know, Hourglass is a 100% vegan cosmetic line. And they always have like really, really high end ingredients. So this feels really, really nice. I love it. All right, anyways though. So yeah, they had a meet and greet in my town at like a Sally's Beauty, and I had to go to Sally's anyway, so I decided to pop in. There was a girl by the name of Donna. Her channel here on YouTube is called Mrs. Hair Today. But she was so, so sweet. And there was also another woman there named Giovanni, which she actually works for Miel, I believe, for like all of their events and everything like that. But I stopped in there and, you know, I spoke to Donna for a little while. I spoke to Giovanni. I picked up a couple of things from Miel. But both girls, super, super sweet. So if you do not know who Miss Hair Today is, make sure that you go and support her channel. She was super sweet. She puts out a lot of natural hair tutorials and, you know, quick styling tips, so on and so forth. But she was super sweet and like she gave me a lot of good information because I just asked her like how she went about actually getting these brand deals, like, you know, the like brand ambassador deals and everything like that. So she gave me a lot of sound advice and she told me to just keep going, keep consistent, so on and so forth. She gave me a shout out on some of her social media. So I wanted to give her a shout out, say, hey girl, thank you so much for, you know, taking the time to speak with me. It was so nice meeting you. You were very beautiful. And yeah, I look forward to seeing more from you. I swear my camera doesn't want to see me win today. Anyways, so yeah, I wanted to thank both Giovanni and Donna for speaking to me that day. It was very, very nice meeting you guys, so on and so forth. Yeah, make sure that you subscribe to her channel. She puts out like hair tutorials, reviews, and everything natural hair related. So I'll make sure that I link her channel down below so you can check it out. And yeah, I'll go ahead and wrap this up. So yeah, again, make sure that you guys give me some feedback about what we talked about today. And yeah, until the next video, I will see you guys later. Peace out.